Hey guys, so not really ever done this before, but just kind of documenting a trip that's coming up tomorrow morning. Me and I think 8 people now are going on a pretty big bike ride. Should be about 4,000 miles, plus or minus, probably plus, knowing Mike. But yeah, it's a 22 Road Glide ST. Kind of ruined it. Put a tour pack on it, 2 up seat. Some people are gonna hate me for it. But yeah, we're going out west. Beartooth Pass, Crazy Horse, a bunch of big bike touristy areas. But with it being all next week, guess what? It's a 2-for-1 Sturgis weekend. It will be a first for me. So hopefully it lives up to what everyone says. So come along with us and share our journeys. I'll be doing some videos at camp. You'll have to forgive some of my friends. They get a little crazy. Good morning. So, it's the day of. Got my bike all loaded up. You can see, hopefully I packed enough. Tour pack's full, saddlebags are full, gas tank's full. So, yeah, I think pretty much set. It's just like every trip. You know you're forgetting something. Just don't know what till you get there. Pretty sure I'm just gonna bum stuff off of everyone. They won't know that until they watch this video though, so then they could be mad at me. But pretty sure 10 hours is the estimated time on the road today. It's gonna be mostly highway for the first 2 days, but it should definitely be fun. So see you on the road. All right, we're here at Queen City Harley. We've got our 7 people right now. We're gonna meet up with a couple people in Indiana. So, in the new building they just opened up, Queen City Harley Davidson in Westchester now, instead of Fairfield. Looks like a freaking museum. hey. Made it to Des Moines, Iowa. Did I say that right? I don't know. I don't care either. So, little update. 9 bikes total. I clocked 595 miles today, but I'm a little slow, so everyone else is clocking about 600 to about 610 from their house. So, but a little update. I forgot to say that we're actually camping. There's Bear over there with his giant condo. Yeah, him. And then there's 2 more over there. Yeah, Mike, way far over there. And then Brian and me right here, acting all primitive. So, yeah, long day riding. We left at 8 o'clock this morning. And probably just got done a little bit ago. Let's see what time it is. It's 7:40. So damn near almost 12 hours on the road between gas stops and everything else. But we here. So, all right, well, I'll see y'all in the morning. Wish us luck on a long night. I think raccoons are rabid around here. So, I'ma die. Good morning, you beautiful freaking people. So we got another long day ahead of us. Should be 600 and maybe 20 miles. Another 10 hours is what it's mapped out to be. Let's see if I got this, if I can pull this up. Yep, so we were in Des Moines last night. Camped out, probably went to bed. Everyone hit the sack probably around 10:30, 11 o'clock. So we are heading to Cottonwood Springs next time. It's the last day that we're on the bike for a long time. 626 miles, it says here. So the good thing about today is it's not gonna be all highway. We're gonna do some back roads, but it's not windy, sweeping or anything like that. It's just supposed to be nice country roads to get there. And then that begins our official fun riding time. So hope you enjoy a little bit of footage from today, and see y'all when we get to the campsite. We're about, I think, 400 miles in out of the 600 so far. I just figured I'd share our little lunch stop with you. Everyone on the trip already knows how excited I am for this. Usually don't do chain restaurants, but there's always those exceptions. Taco John's. Oh my God. It calls me every time I see it. I fall in love with it. First time I had it was on Fort Hood down in Texas. I used to skip PT every morning and just go straight to eat breakfast there every day. And I think that's when I started getting fat. So thanks, Taco John's. I'll see y'all when we get to the campsite. Hey guys, day two. We made it. Just a little shy of 1,200 miles. Yeah, I'm new at all this. I don't know what to say. Can you see that sunset behind us though? Where is it? Where is it? I think it's right there. It's beautiful. It won't focus, but in my picture, that thing is bright orange. So, all right, but tomorrow is a short day. A lot of sightseeing and stuff like that. So hopefully y'all stick with us in the video and see what the Queen City Hog Chapter has been doing so far for the past 2-3 days now. So it's gonna be a long video. Hope y'all stick through it. Good morning, all you cats and kittens. Just kidding, Carol Baskin sucks. So yeah, day three, it's Monday the first. We short riding today, but great riding. We're doing Needles Highway, gonna be on our way to Mount Rushmore, Iron Bridge Road, and Crazy Horse. So once again, if you're sticking around on this video, I really appreciate it. Just make sure you like and subscribe, because give me motivation to keep doing stuff like this on our rides. So see you out on the road. They love it when I turn up the bass. Buffalo Wellum.
I don't know if you guys can make this out or not, but there's a little buffalo right there. Not really little. May growling at us. You hear him? He's like, white people. There's another one back there. Just out there grazing. Living its best life.
up? Well, I made it to the campsite for the night. We ended up doing Needle Highway, the highway that wrapped around Mount Rushmore that was absolutely beautiful. You'll see it in the footage where we go through a couple tunnels. And at the end of the tunnel, it just overlooks, like, you go through the tunnel vision all the way through, and then you just see the monument. We went to Crazy Horse, ended up eating some bison burgers. It was a long wait to get our food for half of us, but it was pretty good. So look at this view we got to wake up to. Frogs having coitus, most likely loud noises, but so beautiful. Mount Rushmore is that way. They ended up taking a little bath in here because we don't have a shower at the campsite today. So a couple of the people just jumped in here and I guess washed off, even though that's ew. Yeah, I don't have swim trunks or sandals because I suck at packing. But it's definitely been a fun day. Stay tuned for more footage. What up? All right. So we're actually on day 4 now. We will be heading towards Wyoming. It's gonna be a 335 mile day. About 6 hours, we're gonna be going through the mountains and everything. But we're actually heading towards Gray Bull, KOA. And we're actually taking, let's see, where is it? Ten Sleep Canyon and Cloud Peak Skyway. So it should be a beautiful ride. Says we'll do it in 6 hours, so seems like it's going to be a slower ride. 6 hours for 300 miles, so there's definitely some twisties in there. But yeah, sleep last night was pretty good. Brian was saying something about some random dude with a chainsaw, but I don't know, I slept through it. So he's still alive, so that's good. But he could have died.
Good morning, Vietnam. So, we got in late last night. I didn't make a video when we got here. We ended up doing Devil's Tower. And then that led us to US Highway 14, which by far is the best road I've ridden so far in my whole life. Truck, car, bike, doesn't matter. It was amazing. So many turns, long sweeping ones, technical turns, switchbacks, everything. And then the scenery was absolutely die for. So before I post this section of my video, you'll see it right before this. And I just hope you enjoy it through the video as much as I did in person. We saw a couple moose, elk, I don't know. I'm not from the area. From my school books, it looked like an elk. But thing was freaking huge. So today would be Beartooth Pass. And that's the only one I can remember because that's the whole reason for this trip. So hopefully y'all stayed with us so far, and see you on the road. Yo.
So, once again, I suck at life. Don't think I recorded coming into the campsite, but we're out in another KOA. We're doing primitive camping back there. You can see Mike and Dan in my tent back in the background. But yeah, they were saying they had bears here getting in people's trash. We didn't see them last night. So Brian the other night said he heard someone with a chainsaw. Come to find out, he was just making fun of me because I snored like a chainsaw, I guess. It sounds pretty scary, but no one died, so that was good. Yesterday we did Chief Joseph Highway, Beartooth Pass. There was still snow up on the mountain a little bit.
And I'm back.
So yeah, GoPro battery died because I suck at life and can't look at a green bar turning red, so yeah, I'm a failure. But anyways, Beartooth Pass was absolutely beautiful. There's a couple scenic overlooks that we stopped at. The peak, it was like a gravel dirt road, and the craters were the size of Mazda Miatas. And I don't know, I think I've had a couple discs in my back compress just from that little bit, but God, was it worth it. It was absolutely amazing. But I just wish that y'all actually realize what these rides were like, because this GoPro is not gonna do any justice. It's just gonna be word of mouth how amazing this trip has been so far. It's for a 10-day trip, just jam-packed with riding and different views. And I think I've heard probably maybe 5 or 6 different like accents since we've been out here. It's just crazy the amount of diversity and like people and stuff, like the Indians, and then you'll have like the mountain people that just straight hick, and it's, I don't know, it's definitely experience to live. And today's just gonna be just as good. It's gonna be a little bit of a rush. We're splitting up in 2 groups, fast and, don't want to be mean, but let's just say not as fast. Everyone's done every route out here so far, but the fast group is taking the, and I get brain farts all the time, is taking Beartooth Pass the reverse way, then Chief Joseph Highway, then we are going back to the scenic route outside Deadwood. And me personally, the type of riding Deadwood was scenic, very technical at the end, and that's the type of riding I love. Like I said before, I've got the 22 ST, and the lean angle on that is just,
It's so forgiving. You could just throw that down and not touch anything at all. And it's been an amazing horse so far. It's loaded down, but still with that 117, it's purely amazing. So see y'all out riding today.
Well, good morning.
Beautiful view out here. We made it to Deadwood Campground. It's inside the Black Mountains National Park. We got here probably about 6, maybe 7 o'clock last night. Cooked some corn and carrots on the grill and just had a long nap. We have no rush today at all. So I think what we're doing is hitting Deadwood Harley, Sturgis Harley, maybe do a little bit of riding around here, but it's supposed to be pretty much a relaxed day. Yes, there's bug guts all over this camera. I wish y'all could see it, but at any time, if there's any blurriness in any of the videos, yeah, you got bugged. So you'll just have to bear through parts of it with me. But yeah, trip's been absolutely amazing so far. We did do the opposite way of where we came 2 days ago. We did Chief Joseph Highway. Well, we did Beartooth Pass first. So much construction up there. They're building a new bridge, you can tell that, and everything. And then we did Chief Joseph Highway, and then 14A that goes over the mountains. And yeah, it's pretty scenic. There's a lot of, like I said, there's a lot of construction, a lot of pilot vehicles you had to follow a couple times to get through one lane traffic. But other than that, it was an amazing ride once again. So hope you all like this video so far, but it's definitely been a blast for me, and hope you guys end up liking and subscribing to the channel, because I plan on doing this a lot more. It's kind of stress relieving in a way. I'm a 8-year active Army vet. Not a serious combat job, but I've had problems when I was in. A couple concussions and stuff ain't. I mean, y'all probably heard in the video that I take long pauses and stuff like that. It's not because I'm dumb. Well, could be. But just stuff like this is soothing for me, and I just appreciate you guys taking the time and enjoying this trip with us. See y'all later throughout the day. Peace.
touching the beaver.
Everyone say hi.
What's up? How you doing, buddy?
What's up? Sturgis, ended up coming back to walk around a little bit. Man, I hope you guys like everything that I'm getting. I'm partial to Cholo bike, so hopefully y'all don't mind about that, but it is packed down here. So much traffic all the way down. Vendors both sides. First manufacturing. So, tons of stuff. Everything you can think of. It's about to rain, so I gotta rush back and get to the campsite because I don't want to get wet. I've seen everything here. The guy stunting down the road. Maybe got some good footage of him. I mean, they even got semis here. Semis! So, then, obviously, boys in blue are here strong. Probably making y'all dizzy flipping this shit around, so I'll see y'all tomorrow when we leave, all right?
Good morning. Man, my beard is looking janky. I haven't had any power or anything to straighten it or put any oils in it. Looking like shit. So y'all saw that I went back to Sturgis last night. That was absolutely a blast. I blasted back last night. It was supposed to rain. I didn't want to get stuck in an area I really didn't know with as much deer and wildlife as out here. So hurried back and just chilled at the campsite the rest of the night. But we are going back this morning early to walk around. I don't know if there's going to be as much people down there, but we plan on getting there around 9, walk around, and then we're actually heading to the Badlands to our next campsite. We're going to be doing some riding around that area. I don't think that much, just mainly sightseeing and touristy stuff, but once again, should be fun. Well, will be fun. Everything we've done so far has been fun. So, once again, hope y'all liked the video, and y'all are at the last couple days. So if you stuck around this long, real MVPs. I'll see you later tonight.
I hope you guys can see me all right. It's a little dark out here and not that great of lighting, so I probably blend in. But I think we just drove through a tornado. I think we could have died. We couldn't see like 5 feet in front of us. Turned our hazards on and we're like, well, let's just follow Mike. Bad idea. I think I have enough water in my boot to fill up Lake Erie or an equivalent sized lake. My hot spots are dry though, so that's a good thing. So these, I just don't think I put them on right. But anyways, the point of this video is to basically say our trip is pretty much done. We're back in Des Moines. And tomorrow's our last day. It's a probably 600 mile trip, but this pretty much concludes it. We're camping tonight, unless if our site's horrible, but the ground's pretty dry here. I don't know if you can see it. So, but it's dry. So hopefully the campsite's dry too, because we got to go further away from where the storm was. But it's definitely been an amazing trip, and for who all has watched this whole video, I very, very appreciate it. Like I said, it's my first time doing a video like this. It's just, it would have been stupid to pass up this opportunity to document everything and share our trip with everyone that couldn't go. So, with the Queen City Hog chapter in Westchester now, it was a pleasure making a video for you guys. See ya. Surprise, I'm back. So, last video I made said I was pretty much done doing footage and everything, but I am. I just wanted to update you guys on mileage and stuff. So, we made it back. Granted, we had two different groups. Oh my God, radio. Granted, we had two different groups on the third day, the more advanced riders went through Beartooth Pass, Chief Joseph Highway, and the scenic mountain way, while the other guys took the highways back. So some of us have more mileage than the others, and then me on top of it, I also went back to Sturgis the night they went back to the campsite. So I have a little bit more mileage than most of them, but as you can see, what we clocked in a 10-day span, 4,047.9 miles. I could probably roll it back and forth in the driveway a couple times just to make it sound a little cooler. But yeah, I just wanted to thank Mike Demko. Some of you guys may know him that watch this video, and half of you guys aren't even gonna know who the hell he is, but he put on this whole ride, and I just think he really deserves a thank you in this video, because I can't imagine how stressful it would be to have 9 people follow you and hope you make a right turn, food, gas stops, everything. So hats off to you, Mike. Really appreciate you putting on this ride. Like I said, it was a bucket list ride from the beginning, with me being a vet, seeing some national monuments, Mount Rushmore and Crazy Horse and stuff like that. It's just an amazing sight. So once again, such an awesome ride, and I hope you guys liked the entire video. So until next time, next ride, car show, whatever, I'm gonna try to get back into making videos. Tell me what I could do better, but please don't hurt my feelings, because I might start my man period or something and go cry in the corner for a little bit. So once again, see y'all. Thanks for watching.